Okay, so today we have a pretty nice old knife. Customer said that he lost it about a year and a half ago when he was deer hunting, and wants me to restore it. Let's do it. Just gonna use this to clean it all up and go from there. Said it's a family heirloom. Handle cleaned up nicely. Says it is made in Orlando, Florida. It's really not that bad a condition for being out in the woods for a year and a half. All right, so now I'm going to see about cleaning this blade up. Really not any deep pitting on it. It's just surface discoloration and rust. It's even sharp on the top. There's a name inscribed right here, but I better not show it just in case the customer wants to keep anonymous. So I'm gonna get some 600 grit. Thank you. 600 grit is really fine, so it's not really taking any metal, any material. It's just cleaning the surface. Customer says this knife is worth, it's priceless to him and his family, so I have to take really good care of it, make it look really good. You can see where the weather is really starting to get into the metal. It's lucky he caught it this soon before that really got in deep and started making some pits. Yeah, so he told me that his grandfather gave it to him in 1970 something. So pretty old knife. Okay, so this blade is made out of something really nice. It's a high quality carbon steel. It is definitely hard, very hard. The thing is probably 61 Rockwell. And the corrosion, it withstood the corrosion so good that it was eaten into the brass here before it really got into the blade. So I'm gonna see if I can clean this up real quick. I'm really curious to know what this company used for their steel. It's good stuff. Being out in the elements as long as it was, it should have rusted up quite a bit more. Especially doing this kind of damage to the brass. The guy said he just got finished with a deer. He was, I guess, skinning it, and it was still dirty. So that's even worse. Looks like an old buck skinning knife to me. Really deep. Almost got it. A lot of detail on this knife. Kind of impressed with it. Whoever built it, they knew what they were doing. They even soldered the blade to the brass there. Now let's go get it on my polisher. I'll set you up over there. Okay. Okay, now let's see if we can put an edge on it. Make it sharp. Okay, so this is a diamond sharpener. I'll just gently put an edge on it like this before I use a leather strap. I'm glad I got that diamond, this diamond sharpener, because this blade is really hard. This is tooled steel for sure. This thing should hold an edge forever. That's pretty good. Look at that. That's thick. And that's without the leather strap so far. All right. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. It is free.